हेलो, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द जियो स्टेशनरी सैटेलाइट। दिस जियो स्टेशनरी सैटेलाइट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड जियो सिंक्रोमस सैटेलाइट। जियो स्टेशनरी सैटेलाइट इज ए सैटेलाइट हुज टाइम पीरियड इज 24 आवर एंड इट्स ऑलवेज रिमेन स्टेशनरी विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द अर्थ। Let this is the earth position, the smaller circle is the symbol of earth and the satellite which is h height above from the surface having mass m moving with orbital velocity v u, right? And if time period is 24 hour is said to be geostationary satellite and it always remains stationary with respect to the earth. What is a normal satellite which is near to the surface? We have seen in that the normal satellite has very high speed, 7.92 kilometer per second normal speed, and its time period is very less, 84.6 minute. But geostationary satellite, the time period is 24 hour. So we want to change its time period from 84.6 minute to 24 hour. See, here the direction is given: north, south, east, west. Since we know that Earth revolves west to east, here in this earth revolve, so satellite must also moves west to east. In such a way that it always remains stationary through a certain particular positions. So that satellite is known as geostationary satellite. In other satellite, in place of sending one, we send a group of satellite for the communication purposes. So once it goes from the communication area, then next will enter at the same time at that position. So communication cannot be interrupted. So in place of sending a group of satellite, if you want to send only one satellite, then it should be geostationary satellite, right? So we may say that a satellite which appears to be at a fixed position at a definite point according to here the diagram, right? Then if it is at a definite height, so it will be stationary with respect to the earth, right? To an observer, where is the position observer? It is surely at earth. So we may write observer on earth is called geostationary satellite, right? So it means for a geostationary satellite, the time period must be 24 hour. 24 hour mean 24 into 60 into 60 second, right? So we want to calculate how much height must be required for the height of geostationary satellite revolving around the earth. So we will see the formula for height of a satellite. It is given by formula T square Re square G by 4 pi square minus H, this factor in a bracket of cube root. So time period is here given. It is a radius of earth. Radius of earth is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter, we know. Acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square. पाई वी नो 3.14. पुटिंग दिस ऑल वैल्यू हियर इन द फॉर्मूला, सो हाइट ऑफ सैटेलाइट एच कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड टी स्क्वायर, सी हियर इज टाइम पीरियड इज 24 into 60 होल स्क्वायर इन टू रेडियस ऑफ अर्थ 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter, we know the radius of earth, into acceleration due to gravity 9.8 by 4 into 3.14 the value of pi whole square minus h, this is in the formula, minus re, not h, re. So re is given 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter. By solving this whole expression, one may write it is approximately 36,000 meter or 36,000 kilometer. So if you want to launch a geostationary satellite which always remains stationary to an observer on the earth, so its height must be this height h, which is represented here 36,000 kilometer away from the earth surface. And we know the radius is only 6,400 kilometers of the earth. So it is much more than the radius of earth is required to launch a geostationary satellite. So this is for height of a satellite. Now we want to see what should be orbital velocity. Velocity of geo stationary satellite. To see the orbital velocity of geostationary satellite, first of all, see we want to what should be the orbital velocity formula. This is a formula VO is equal to RE under root G RE plus H. Now putting this value here, R is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 under root. G is 9.8, we know. Re plus H. Re is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 plus height is 3.6 into. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10 to the power 7 here. And after calculating this, orbital velocity of a satellite is approximately, it's come around very less value, approximately 3.1 kilometer per second. Very less value means my, see, understand, in comparison to the a satellite which launch near to the surface above 300 kilometer approximately is almost 8 kilometer per second. So comparison to this, it is a less. So orbital velocity must be 3.1 kilometer per second. Right? So we want to see here the essential condition for geostationary satellite, that is the conclusion on whole mathematical calculation which is represented here. That is, the first is a geostationary satellite must be approximately 36,000 kilometer away from equator of earth. That is, this height is 36,000 kilometer. Now we are going to see the second point. The second point is the time period T should be how much? 24 hour. This 24 hour can be said as same as time period of Earth around its axis. So we know that Earth revolves around the sun and also spins on its own axis. So if when it's rotate on its axis, the time period is 24 hour, and that 24 hour is taken for the time period of geostationary satellite, means as Earth this rotate on its axis, in same way the satellite must also rotate. In that condition, it always remains stationary comparison to the observer on Earth surface. Its orbital velocity, must be 3.1 kilometer per second approx. This is clear. Orbital velocity must be to keep. So when we take this height, it can be remain stationary only if their orbital velocity of launching at that position is 3.1 kilometer per second. Now fourth point. It must revolve west to east as Earth spins. And this final point is very important for a geostationary satellite, that is, it should always in the orbit concentric. It should not change its center and coplanar with equatorial plane, so that orbit of satellite is always normal to the axis of rotation from Earth. So see here these 5 points regarding this: the height 36,000 kilometer, time period 24 hour, orbital velocity 3.1 kilometer per second, revolve, see very carefully, west to east, and while it's rotate, its center should not be changed, one point, and it should be always coplanar with equatorial plane, like that it always remains normal to the axis of rotation of the Earth. In that condition, it is possibility. The first geostationary satellite is launched by USA, United States of America, in 1962. That satellite was Telstar. My country, India, also launched InSat 2A, InSat 2B, and InSat 2C. In that, in series of insight 2B and 2C is geostationary satellite launched by India. So this is about geostationary satellite.